ready to be lysed outside. Okay, so this is about the lytic phase. Now let's talk about a little bit about the lysogenic cycle. So what is the mode of action for the lambda lysogenic cycle in case of lambda repressor in case of lysogenic cycle? Now in this case, the repressor binds to the OR1 because of its higher affinity, right, to this sequence. Usually the repressor is having higher affinity to OR1. So that is very, very important foundation. Actually, I haven't talked about that. Usually the repressor or Crow repressor usually binds with OR1 with much more affinity, then a little lesser affinity with OR2, then a little less affinity with OR3. Right? That's how the affinity is going on. Now, as at the very beginning, the repressor is present in very few concentration, it first binds with the OR1 region because that is having the highest affinity region. So it binds to the OR1 section here with the higher affinity. Now then the interaction with the OR1 and OL1 blocks the transcription from PR and PL, but not from PRM. So usually blocks the transcription in this direction. So simply it blocks it here in the opposite direction, which is required to produce the proteins for lytic cycle. And that's very logical because we don't want to turn it into the lytic cycle. We want lysogenic cycle. So it will block all the necessary genes that are required for the transcription of the protein products required from the lytic cycle. And it will promote all the other proteins required to finally turn into the lysogenic cycle. Right? So they will start the promoter PRM here. So now the polymerase will come and bind to the promoter PRM and will start transcribing genes present in the left hand direction in this picture. Now when more repressor is available, a second dimer binds to the OR2 cooperatively, right? So as it binds to the OR2 cooperatively, this results in enhanced transcription from PRM by repressor interacting with the RNA polymerase. Now the repressor is kind of interacting with the RNA polymerase. As a result of this interaction that is visualized by this image here, the RNA polymerase is kind of enhanced to act properly here. So here are the repressor first bind to OR1. Now due to the slight more concentration, more repressor coming and bind to the OR2, and then they will be attached to the RNA polymerase and telling RNA polymerase to act pretty finely and properly. And the interaction of OR1 or OR2 with this Crow proteins, what they require here, they require the presence of another important protein called C1. Now this C1 and C2, both of these proteins are required to enhance the activity of this repressor there to finally turn into the lysogenic cycle. So then it will be bound to the RNA polymerase. It will tell the RNA polymerase to move on and synthesizing those proteins required for the lysogen conversion into the lysogenic cycle. Okay, so here comes a C2 protein that also enhances this kind of transcription. C1 protein also enhances the transcription. In both the way, it enhances the transcription and then enhances the transcription of the genes called the regions called ZIX and INT, which is required finally to INT is the gene which is required for the integration of this phage genome with the host cell genome, and XIS is a sequence which is required to release or cut out this phage genome from the host cell after the lysogeny has been accomplished. Okay, so let's look at here. So once everything is kind of going on, and there are sites called ATTP. Remember, in this picture also we have found the site ATTP, and two types of site is there, ATTP and ATTB. Now ATTB is present in the bacterial chromosome, that's why it's called that P. ATTP is present in the phage chromosome, that's why it's called the phage or ATTP. So in the ATTPB, we are having this kind of sequence. We can see it's a kind of same stretch of sequence in both the case, in case of bacteria as well as virus. So they are having a same type of structure. So recombination event is very much possible between this lambda chromosome with the bacterial chromosome. So here it goes. It is kind of attached via this BB with PP, is kind of recombination there. After the recombination is established, this phage genome is kind of incorporated to this host cell or bacterial genome. And now the stretch of phage genome embedded inside the bacterial genome is termed as prophage. Many students find this prophage term confusing, but prophage means a section of the phage genome which is being inserted inside the host bacterial cell genome. Okay, now as it is producing this prophage, as you can see at both the terminal, it is having P prime and PB prime, and then the rest of the genes for bacteria is present in both the directions. Now it is called the lysogenic chromosome. Okay, so after they form this lysogenic chromosome, it is very, very important to finally turn it into the lytic parts, because we know these are temperate parts. They can convert their strategy from lysogenic cycle to lytic cycle in future. So how they came to do that? So let's talk about that. Now what we know about here, that high concentration of repressor, when we having more and more crow there, right? So dimer start to bind an OR3. As it start to bind this OR3, they are kind of switch off the transcription from this PRM, right? And due to the overlapping sequence with the RNA polymerase binding site, this will not allow the polymerase to further bind with this PRM. So the transcription previously blocked in this direction, now it is being blocked in left hand side also, right? So the transcription is blocked in both the ways, and the lysogenic cycle will be repressed in this condition. And the only way to repress it by the higher repressor concentration, because this is the only way that the repressor or crodimer will bind. Crodimer will bind to the ORC or OLC, because this third operator region is the most, it is having the least affinity towards the binding of crow proteins. Okay. Now let's talk about the prophase induction. Now this particular phenomena is termed as, it is simply the release of the lysogen from the lysogenic phase or lysogenic condition, right? So if you look at, this is the lysogen, and inside this somewhere in this bacterial genome, there is the incorporation of our path genome, right? And we know that sometimes in future, when they find the environment is difficult to stay in and the bacteria is kind of in tough situation, it can die. So in this case, the phage genome start to emerge as again lytic phage, and then start lysing the bacterial cell and can come out. So how to revert the lysogenic cycle into lytic cycle? So lysogenic to lytic, in this case it is called the phage or prophage induction. So in this case, what they require any kind of stress. Now what kind of stress here? The stress here can act as DNA damage due to any kind of irradiation, like UV radiation, or any kind of chemical stress, something like that. Due to this kind of stress, when the DNA of the bacteria is turned into the single-stranded DNA, and it also starts producing or expression of some proteins called REC proteins, right, which is required for the repair mechanism of the DNA repair mechanism of bacteria. So as the REC proteins start to emerge there, that the REC protein will come and they are kind of degrade this repressor that are present there. So they are kind of block or cleave all the crow repressors that are bound to OR1, 2 and 3 in all this direction. So as they are cleaving this repressor in these particular stages, they are kind of triggering this prophase to finally come out. How? Because they kind of inhibiting this crow, and all the regulation from controlling between lytic and lysogenic is kind of open up now. And then especially they start expressing the genes that are present in left direction as well as in right direction. Both the cases, the transcription is kind of on, because there is no crow protein to regulate that, right? Because there is, the crow is the only master protein to control it, right? Now in this case, as the left region or the transcription is going on from the left promoter region, it is providing us XIS regions or proteins, which are required for the excision of this phage genome from the bacterial genome. How? So here it is again, the process will be done via the reverse recombination stage. So again, they kind of form bulge like that, and from this B prime to B and P prime to P, the crossover will be done and the phage genome will come out. And as the phage genome will come out, then they will start producing more and more. Remember, they will start producing as they are also transcribing from the right promoter region, they will start producing more crow here. So as they will produce more and more crow here, the crow will bind to the OL1, 2 and C, and then enhance the transcription in right hand side, block the transcription in left hand side. So it will convert it into the lytic cycle here. A lytic cycle will be done, lysis of the cell will be established, and then the phage particles can come out.